Hey there, it's Andrew. Today we're going to be covering the 5 best ways to recover deleted files on your Mac. And by the way, before this video starts, if you guys end up liking it and want to see more like it, always be sure to leave us a like down below and consider subscribing to the channel. So everyone's been there, right? 1 minute a file's there and the next it's not. It happens. But lucky for you, today I've got 5 killer methods that we're going to be going over that'll give you a really good shot of getting those files back, regardless of what they are. And so jumping right in here to method number 1, sometimes files can disappear without even really being deleted. And so, although it sounds basic, the first thing we can do is check places like the Mac's trash bin and do a quick finder search just to make sure that you didn't misplace the file by accident. So to recover files from your Mac's trash bin, just go ahead and open it and give it a quick look just to make sure that the file isn't there. Now, if it does happen to be there, go ahead and select it, right click, and hit put back. And this will restore the file back to where you left it. A quick finder search can also really help to find the lost files as well, if you happen to know the name or extension. To recover files with Finder, just open a new Finder window and search the location or general area where you remember the file to be with the search bar in the top right. And that should reveal the file where you can copy it and use it however you need. So those steps are, albeit pretty simple, but preliminaries to the more robust solutions later on in this video. But I did just want to cover them, as they shouldn't be overlooked, as oftentimes the simple solution is the best one. But with that being said, let's move on to the second way you can actually recover lost or deleted files on your Mac, which is going to be using Time Machine or Time Machine Snapshots. So I've talked about this method a few times before, and that's for a good reason. As far as Mac file recovery goes, whenever you delete or lose something, it's about as robust as it gets. And honestly, if you've got it enabled, it's one of the first things you should try. But you may have noticed that I mentioned both Time Machine as well as local snapshots. Both can be used, but what's the main difference? Well, everyone knows Time Machine. It's the built-in macOS backup software designed to create save points on an external hard drive of all your files on your Mac at set times throughout the week, month, or year. But local snapshots, on the other hand, work a little bit differently. So they use the same sort of concept, the same interface as Time Machine, but the save is directly to your Mac, and each save only lasts 24 hours at a time. However, the external drive that you normally use with Time Machine for your regular Time Machine backups is not actually required in order to use local snapshots. So that's what makes it very advantageous in the case you don't have that drive or you straight up didn't set it up. You can still use the local snapshots in this case to get your files back. And so knowing this, we can use both of these to our advantage. Okay, so first, to recover files from a regular Time Machine backup, connect your backup drive to your Mac and ensure it's connected. Next, open up Time Machine and navigate to the location where your files were before they were deleted. Finally, navigate through the time selector on the right side until you reach a point where the file is present and restore it back to your Mac. And to restore deleted files from a local snapshot, the process is very similar, but it actually starts with making sure your normal Time Machine drive is not connected to your Mac. Then all you gotta do is open up Time Machine, navigate to the location where your files were, and restore them just as before. All right, so Time Machine is awesome, we all know that, but let's shift gears here for a minute. What about more complex recovery situations? Maybe you emptied your Mac's trash bin by accident, or you just straight up don't even use Time Machine. Well, in method number 3, we're going to be using data recovery software called Disk Drill to recover the permanently deleted files on our Mac. Disk Drill is awesome. I've spoken about it at length before, and I'm going to keep talking about it because when it comes to data recovery, it is as good as it gets. The obvious thing you want in data recovery software is results, just solid results. And Disk Drill offers this in spades thanks to its advanced recovery algorithms that only get better with time. It can recover virtually any file type from any storage type, anything from camera raw files on a CFast 2.0 card to MOV video files and MP3s on your old external hard drives. It's wicked fast, easy to use, constantly updated, and Disk Drill 5 for Mac enables you to preview any and all files found before recovery, so you know exactly what you're getting ahead of time without needing the pro version. I'll include a link down below for you to download it and try it out for yourself, and I think you'll be impressed. But once you've done that, here's how you can recover deleted files on your Mac using Disk Drill. So first of all, to get started, go ahead and download Disk Drill from the official website, which will be linked down below in the description. Then once you've got it downloaded, go ahead and install it on your Mac. And once it's installed, open it up. And if the missing files were located on an external drive, go ahead and connect that to your Mac now as well. Now at this point, you'll arrive at the disk list, a list of all the available drives connected to your Mac and able to be scanned. All you gotta do is simply select the drive you want to scan for files and hit search for lost data. Now as Disk Drill scans for data, you'll begin to see different categories of files begin to populate on the screen. These can also be browsed in real time during the scan as well, which is pretty cool. Now once the scan is finished, you can review the files that were found here. From here, you can browse the files in a number of different ways, like category, file name, file type, etc. Now you are able to preview each file recovered at this point, but something you also get is a recovery estimate for each file, letting you know the odds of that file getting recovered successfully and in full. Very helpful. Now once you've found the files you need, put a check mark next to them, hit recover, and choose your save location. Now one important thing to note here is that you should ideally save all of the recovered files from disk drill to a different spot you're trying to recover from. So in that case, I'm just going to export them to an external USB device. Now just hit next, and that will recover all files to that selected location. All right, so with the main meat and potatoes of this video covered, I wanted to go over two additional methods that still provide amazing results when it comes to data recovery on your Mac. And the first is iCloud. So iCloud needs no introduction. If you own an Apple device, you've definitely heard of it. And in fact, if you own an Apple device at all, you even have a share in that storage space for free. And so the good news is most people will have some, if not all, of their files on their Mac backed up to iCloud somewhere. And this usually includes files and folders on your desktop and in your documents, your photos in the Photos app, and some other data depending on how much storage you have and what kind of iCloud configuration you have set up as well. And so to recover deleted files on your Mac using iCloud, you can do the following. Just log into iCloud on your Mac. Then on the dashboard, you can browse all the files that have been saved to the cloud. There's even a recently deleted folder you can check as well. But from here, you can download files and folders onto your Mac or copy them to a specific spot that you need. The one quick thing to keep in mind here, though, is that synchronization also matters. Of course, it depends on what your iCloud settings are, but for instance, if you delete a photo on your phone, it'll also delete from your Mac while still remaining in iCloud. This is a really, really great fail-safe that honestly, if you hadn't taken advantage of it yet, you really should. And finally, method number five, to round out the list, something pretty new, has to do with Apple Music, but I still think it's pretty cool. So this is a bit of a unique situation, but if you happen to delete a track or a set of tracks from your Apple Music library on your Mac, there's a pretty easy and handy feature built right into Apple Music you can use to restore your entire library with like one click. So to restore your Apple Music library, you can use the Sync Library feature to restore the tracks to your Mac. So go ahead and open Apple Music, navigate to Music in the menu bar and hit Settings. Make sure the box next to Sync Library is checked and hit OK. Now what this will do is it will sync your Apple Music library between your phone and your Mac and make both of them equal so that just in case you happen to delete something or misplace something, it's a quick and easy way to get that stuff back. And there we have it. Those are the five best ways to recover deleted files on your Mac in 2024. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video and you got something out of it. If you did, leave us a like down below, subscribe to the channel, and always be sure to comment what you want to see down below. We always love to hear from you guys in the comments. So take care, guys. We appreciate you. Bye-bye.